So good afternoon. It is so nice to see you all here. I'm glad to have this chance to gather for our annual leadership chapel. Today we will hear from Tate and from Leah, each of whom will share their thoughts about leadership before announcing next year's senior prefect and honor board chair. But before I pass things over to them, I want to say a few words myself about leadership. When we think about leadership in high school, and this was certainly the case when I was in high school, and even beyond high school, we often think about the honor and the prestige that comes with being elected, with being chosen. Often, and really too often, I hear people, and not just students, talk about leadership positions as things to put on college applications, as popularity contests, as things along those lines. And in truth, as our current school leaders have so beautifully demonstrated this year, leadership is about service. Certainly, to be elected, to be chosen by one's peers is a great honor, and that can't be forgotten. And I think I speak for the entire community when I congratulate all of you standing here, both this year's and last year's honor boards and prefects, or this year's and next year's, I should say. What we have to remember, however, is that getting elected is just the start. The service that your school leaders perform on your behalf is significant, and so much of it you never even see. The time and effort that these people give to our community is huge. Hours and hours. Whether it's setting the tone for our campus, leading assemblies, determining honor code violations, planning events, giving us speeches, attending meetings, our school leaders serve. They work hard for us. Today, as we honor our outgoing and incoming school leaders, they're not quite outgoing yet. I just do want to note that. You guys still have a third of the year left to keep serving us. But as we honor our outgoing and incoming school leaders, I hope we can all reflect on everything that our leaders do on our behalf. Truly, they are embodiments of our mission statement. They are already leading lives of constructive service, and they deserve our thanks. So without further ado, this year's senior prefect, Tate Michelson.
After Molly announced my name last year as the next senior prefect, I was at a complete loss for words and felt utter disbelief. All I could think about was everything that lied ahead and the work that would be required to follow up the amazing year that the previous prefects had given us. My heart was racing, and I stood in the chapel after everyone had left with my hands on my head, wondering how I would get through the following year. It would be an understatement to say I was terrified. Now, to the next senior prefect, I've learned quite a few things through my experience. First, you are not alone. The five of you are a unit, and you stand together to accomplish the betterment of the community. Never hesitate to reach out for help, and know that your fellow prefects are right there with you. Second, embrace adversity. Throughout this year, the five of us have been faced with challenges that have required us to deepen our communication and trust the decisions that we make. This leads me to my third and probably most important lesson that I've learned. Have confidence. You need to be confident that you will be able to fulfill this role. You need to be confident in the things you say, the actions you take, and be deliberate in your planning. And you need to be especially confident that the whole community has your back. Dear 2021 senior prefect, some people need to learn how to be a leader, where I think you are a natural one. Your powerful and influential presence has already made an impact on the community more than you can comprehend. Whether you know it or not, I believe you are equipped with all the qualities and tools to not only succeed, but to thrive in this position. You're going to do astonishing things, Makai, and I have full confidence in you. Congratulations to your 2020-2021 senior prefect, Makai Murray!
Hey. What direction is the Honor Board moving towards? This is a perpetual question we have often asked ourselves. Is it purely a place of punishment or something else? But this garners the question of what does it mean to be a person on the Honor Board? Of course, you have to be honorable with all the ambiguity that comes with that. But after being able to serve on it, I have learned that being on the Honor Board encompasses so much more. It requires compassion, empathy, and understanding. To be unwavering in your values or morals, but simultaneously not being afraid to gain perspective and even change yours. To be thinking about what betters both the person and the school. So when an individual appears before the Honor Board and receives a punishment, that only scratches the surface of the significance of what the Honor Board represents in the community. So, what direction is the Honor Board moving towards? Well, I have a feeling that the 2020-2021 Honor Board Chair embodies it. This student happens to be one of the most genuine individuals I have ever met. They have a strong sense of self and a distinct levelness. When I think of them, I can't help but think of the word balance. Maybe it's their poise or their stable disposition. But I think balance is so important because it allows for evaluation and constant progression. Liam, although you are a silent leader, your influence and honorable qualities have spoken volumes within the community. I don't know if I directly answered the question of the direction the Honor Board is moving towards, but I think you will, because whatever positive direction we are moving towards, you and your fellow Honor Board members will push for it. I could not be happier to announce that the 2020-2021 Honor Board Chair is Liam Smith.